everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I want to show you how you can detail your vehicle in your garage and do this for a relatively affordable cost. So behind me here is my 2012 Audi R8, and over roughly the last 10 years that this vehicle has been out on the road and having multiple owners to it, I don't see any signs that any of the owners kept this paint protected. There's no remnants from PPF or paint protection. It's never had a paint correction, and I don't see any signs that it's ever been ceramic coated either. So over the last 10 or so years, this paint has been fully exposed to the elements. You can see there's some chips up front that I'm going to fix in another video, but over the last 10 or so years, I wouldn't say it's in the worst condition, but of course it could be better. Same with your vehicle too, if you've had it for a while and there's been no protection to it. I want to bring that shine back. White is a color that hides a lot, so it's very hard to see all the imperfections in it compared to a black car, and I really want to get rid of those as best as I can and bring that shine back to this car. If you like to keep your car well maintained, and especially keeping the paint well maintained, this is a great project that you can do. Take a few hours and get that car shiny and looking good. So in today's video, the first thing that we need to do in order to start this project is to wash the car. So we went ahead and pulled it out of the garage. You can see that we have a portable canopy over it as well, because we were doing this in the heat of the day, and you don't want the paint to get all hot, especially when you're applying coatings to it. That can interfere with how the coating reacts to that paint. So we were trying to keep it as cool as possible and give the car a good bath. So you can see just going around it, doing a normal wash, getting all the dirt and grime, anything that would be on it, pollen, whatever it may be, to get it nice and clean. And so from there, we pulled it back into the garage so that way we could stay out of the elements and work in a nice cool environment. And so from there, we started with the clay bar. I'll have a link to all of these products down in the description below. I decided to try this instead of the traditional clay bar simply because it's much larger, so we have a greater surface area, and it doesn't look like you'll get a hand cramp with the size. So it's almost like a nice ergonomical position, kind of like a mouse for your computer, and you can use this multiple times. So I really like that idea of being able to use this on multiple cars for multiple different times. I also have the lubricant for it too. You never want to use a clay bar on dry paint, so you always want to make sure you have some kind of liquid like that. And then the last thing for today's video is using the Hydrosealix off-road ceramic coating. Now, while this is an off-road coating, I use this on my Tacoma. If you want to check out that video, it made a huge difference between going through the mud and being able to clean the vehicle afterwards, between the before and after sides. If you want to see all those details, definitely check out that video. But I decided to use this ceramic coating for my R8 to keep this in really good shape, keep all the remnants off this, whatever may get on it. I dry this car as much as possible, so I always want to make sure it is looking in great shape. So you can see that we have the liquid that we are using as well, and spraying that in the areas that we were starting with. We are keeping it to a small area just so we could concentrate on the different areas around the vehicle. I did not use this on the carbon fiber, so I was just using this on the paint itself. And then you want to make sure, as I mentioned earlier, not to have any dry spots. So along with spraying this on the paint itself, I was actually spraying it on the backside of the clay bar as well. So after a few passes, I noticed I could see some dirt spots, kind of everything was gathering up into one spot. So I used this liquid to help clean off the backside of this before I continued to use more passes or do more passes along the side of the vehicle. So you just want to make sure that nothing is getting kind of built up on the backside of the clay bar. And obviously you'll go around the entire vehicle, just work in sections. It makes it a lot more easier. Yet at the same time, it's not really hard work. We're not going into great detail on doing this, but the end product I think looks really good. So it's not hard work. It's just a little bit time consuming, but it's definitely worth it if you want that shine to your paint. We'll be right back. so that was the second step in detailing this vehicle. And then the last step for today was using the ceramic coating. So there's a process to do this. We have the instructions for both of these, of course, on the back of the packaging. For the ceramic coating, you want to use microfibers. And I also got these from Hydrocelix as well. So we have multiple microfibers to use. There's one for your first pass, and then you're going to use another one for your second pass. And we did the same thing that we did with the clay bar, just working in sections, going around the entire vehicle. This time I used that on the carbon fiber just to make that sparkle a little bit more. And obviously going around the entire vehicle, you can see that shine. The paint also has a much different feeling to it. Without the ceramic coating, it felt very dry and you couldn't glide your hand across the paint. But now having the ceramic coating on there, I can feel I'm gliding just like on an ice rink, and it feels much better. The paint also looks a lot more shiny as well. And then with this water test that we did, you can see the water run right down off of the hood and then immediately bead up. We also decided to use this ceramic coating on the windows, so when I'm driving this in the rain, it will hopefully bead up much quicker, and I may not have to use the wiper blades as much, but even just driving this car in the rain in general, all of it will bead up and it will make it much easier to clean and leave less water spots as well, so you won't see those remnants from the water, and it'll keep your car looking that much cleaner. But I think that's gonna wrap it up for today's video, detailing the Audi R8 in the garage. This is something that you can do in one day, a few hours. You can get your car looking much cleaner. It'll have that shine that you're looking for, and it'll keep it in really good shape. So if you enjoyed today's video, give it a huge thumbs up. Consider smashing that subscribe button if you'd like to stay up to date on our daily uploads. And I'll see you in the next video.